The desecration of our sacred institutions of state, which holds us together, is unending. We have never gone this low before. These political invaders are in Akwa Ibom attempting to use 5 former lawmakers to impeach a speaker and a governor in a 26-state House of Assembly. They are in Rivers State using the lies of Akinfakwa legislators to steal the rights of the people. They are in Kwara, Benue, Kogi, Imo, and so on. The opposition have been informed of ongoing moves, opposition vote of no confidence on the Inspector General of Police and rejection of his extension in office. The opposition have been informed of ongoing moves to extend the services of the Inspector General of Police, who is due to retire on 15 January 2015, to allow him reenact the 1983 police back electoral fraud. Let it be known to President Buhari that any such move shall not augur well for the credibility of the electoral process, and it will weaken the institution of the police. The President is hereby put on notice that any attempt to extend the services of the Inspector General of Police beyond his 15 January 2019 retirement date shall be resisted within the ambit of the law, as any such act will be viewed by Nigerians as tantamount to hiring a machinery to help him rig his way into office. Scientific rigging, plot to preload card readers, pressure and INEC, and plot to reintroduce incident form. The opposition has also been informed of the plot to attempt to secure collaboration of the INEC to make card readers available for preloading to the APC, who will use the already collected PVC numbers generated during the controversial trader money cash for vote policy headed and supervised by the Vice President, where they have allegedly paid $10,000 each for these PVC numbers. These numbers will be inputted into the clone PVCs and used for preloading of the card reader. It's also important for us to know that in Oshun, where you had over 50,000 as accredited voters, only 20,000 turned out to vote, meaning that the candidate was preloaded even before the election. Because in Oshun, it was after accreditation you are given ballot to vote. So how come there that gap? There is also information that there is undue pressure on the INEC chairman to return President Buhari's sister, Amina Zakari, as head of operation and ICT of the commission. The commission is currently under intense pressure by the presidency and the APC to fine-tune arrangement to restore the use of incident forms where the use of candidate fails, as against the repeat of such election where the machine failed. The presidency should know that this collaboration is dead on arrival and cannot succeed. We hereby call and urge the INEC chairman to insist that where the president refuses to sign the electoral act in the next 72 hours, that candidate accreditation should be the only form of accreditation in the 2019 election, as experimented in the Ekiti and Oshun governorship election. No other form of accreditation other than candidate accreditation shall be acceptable to the opposition. Plot to arrest opposition leader and illegal withdrawal from our national coffers. Another component part of this plot is the compilation of lists of opposition leaders who will be arrested on trumped-up charges. The allegation of linking the Senate President Bukola Saraki to the offer bank robbery is just a tip of the iceberg. More of such allegations are on board and will be unfolded in the coming weeks. Frivolous charges of corruption will be brought up and many will be arrested for laughable allegations, just like the case of the political activist Deji Adeyinju, who upon being granted bail by the court have been rearrested by the police and charged for a frivolous offense. But Nigerians will not be deterred in their resolve to send a dictator out of office for the good of Nigeria and her citizens. The regime has also failed to give account of enormous sums of money running into trillions, which it had illegally withdrawn from our nation's coffers, which have obviously been warehoused for buying of votes in February. Billions have been missing from NNPC, LNG, NEMA, etc. Nigerians are daily seeing the exposure of lies and propaganda with which they have been ruled for the almost 4 years. In conclusion, we hereby put agents of this regime on notice that we have resolved to seek US, UK, and EU support to place visa ban on these enemies of democracy so that they will not escape justice and judgment where they plunge this country into crisis. Nigerians and the international community are hereby notified that the claim of President Muhammadu Buhari that he will allow a free and fair election is without any commitment, and it is like believing that Idi Amin will respect human rights. Thank you all for coming.